Stay motivated raising kids. Why raising a second multilingual child requires more commitment? With the first child, parents tend to be careful and prepare everything in detail because it's an exciting time where they start tapping into unknown fields. Once the second child comes along, things are quite different and more complex than before. Although most parents want to give all of their children the same chances, the fact is, it is practically impossible to raise them the same way. Hello there and welcome to Multilingual Family, a vlog for cosmopolitan people like you that helps you raise your multilingual child successfully. On this channel, I share with you lots of tips, know-how, and useful material, so consider subscribing to this channel and my mailing list. Check out the link below in the description for more support. In this video, I talk about the challenges of raising a second multilingual child and what perspective you can take to be able to sleep better at night. I hear mothers say all the time, imagine I raised my kids the same way and they turned out completely different. That just sounds a little odd to me, because there is no way, even though it would be nice, to raise children the same way. To begin with, nobody stays the same. We all change, mature, learn more, grow, expand our minds. So the person you were at the time your first child was born is not the same years later. You might have learned some lessons from your mistakes. You might have adjusted your points of view. You might have had life-changing experiences throughout that time. All of that affects the way you act. Besides, your second child is a different being. What might have worked out with your first baby won't necessarily be a success with your second child. My baby boy is a toddler now, but when I look back, I have to say that I felt quite often a bit guilty. I felt that I was being unfair to him. Not because I wanted, but much more because I couldn't help it. Having more than one child puts you in a challenging situation because you have a lot more things to get done, but in less time. And you constantly have to split yourself into two. You're sort of juggling the whole time, hoping that all the balls stay in the air somehow. The good news in all of this is that your children learn a very important skill, which is to wait. And that could even give their creativity a nice boost. I say normally to my friends, with the first child, you are busy. With the second child, you are surviving. And with the third, I don't know what happens after the third. I just bow in front of all the parents that have more than two kids, because seriously, I don't know how you stay sane. Okay, let's stop joking now and get real. I'm gonna tell you how a change of perspective helped me sleep better at night and stop feeling guilty for not being able to be there for my son the same way I was for my daughter. Check out the next ideas. First of all, experience versus motivation. As I mentioned before, after you go through the birth, baby, toddler, preschool years, and so on, you gain a lot of parenting experience. From how to change a diaper to knowing how to sing children's songs, you've done it all. So when the second multilingual child comes along, you just repeat or adjust things you were not happy with and do it all again. But precisely because you're repeating it all, your parenting motivation might slightly be lower than the first time. And that is why raising a second multilingual child requires more commitment. I know several families that have done a great job passing their minority language to their first child. The second one has gotten less attention and therefore is not as fluent as the first one. And the third one, unfortunately, doesn't speak the minority language at all. This doesn't have to be the case, but it still happens. So knowing that, what can you do to be equally fair to all of your children? What I have come to realize is that I need to actively find time slots during the week where I'm 100% committed to my second child. I motivate myself to do it because I want to be fair with both of my children. I want to treat them as equally as possible and give them similar chances. During that time slot, I give my son as much quality exposure in the minority language as I can. I know that it's not the same amount of time as I used to spend with my daughter, but I'm also aware of the fact that I'm now more experienced and know that my son can profit from that, which balances things a bit out again. Please hit that like button if you are getting value out of this and share this channel with your friends. Thank you. Second, siblings to play and learn from. This is a huge advantage for the second multilingual child, which gets very fast used to having an older sibling to play with and learn from. Children acquire a lot of new skills from other children. In fact, sometimes they learn from other kids better than from grown-ups. In school, for example, I often use stronger students as teachers. They love the role of being an expert and learn quite a lot themselves by explaining content to other students. At the same time, other kids tend to pay more attention to their peers and learn from them fast. So having this advantage of your second multilingual child in mind can help you relax a bit, knowing that he or she is also profiting a lot from your older child. Third, material and language exposure. It takes some time as fresh parents to get into parenting mode and learn about what books to buy, what stories to read, what videos to watch, what toys to use. Your second child jumps over that initial phase and is born into a family that is already settled with multilingual books, toys, children, music, etc. I remember that when I was pregnant and up until Aya started talking, I had to make a huge effort to talk to her all the time and had what felt like a constant monologue because she was a baby and couldn't speak yet. That was significantly easier with Niels. When he came along, I was always involved in conversations because my daughter was most of the time around. That means that my second multilingual child had a lot of natural language exposure of real conversations, which my first child didn't. To sum up, raising multilingual children is a constant challenge. It requires commitment and a strong vision that is going to help you stay motivated raising kids and carry on with your plans in good and bad times. I don't feel guilty towards my son anymore because I'm aware that it's impossible to raise kids in the exact same way. I also know that each child can profit from different things at different times and that builds their unique characteristics. I only make sure that I love them both and commit to do my best. What do you think? Let me know in the comment section. Thanks so much for watching this video called Stay Motivated Raising Kids, Why Raising a Second Multilingual Child Requires More Commitment. Watch my other videos to get more useful information. This was Multilingual Family. Keep on doing a great job and talk to you soon.